Hi everybody. Namaste. My light welcomes your light. And this is the first of our seven different classes, all about the different seven elevating chakras. And this is my beautiful studio called the Santosha Shack. And I hope you like my simple arrangement. We're going to do a class together. I'm going to speak it. So even if you have your eyes closed, you don't have to look at the screen. And this is designed for anybody to follow. So let's go. And we're going to begin with an invocation. I'll tell you about this mantra later, but just listen to me. Om Namah Shivaya Gurave Satchidanandamurtaye Nishvrahmachaya Shantaya Nirananbhaya Tejase. Om Namah Shivaya Gurave Satchidanandamurtaye Nishvrahmachaya Shantaya Niranambhaya Tejase. Om Namah Shivaya Gurave Satchidanandamurtaye Nishvrahmachaya Shantaya Niranambhaya Tejase. As I prepare my mat, I'll tell you about the invocation. So you may not know it or not, but I have the heater on, and I'm going to put some music on, because I love music. You don't have to play music when you do your yoga practice, but I love beautiful music, and this is Jay Utah's Loveland. He gave me permission to use it, how nice of him. And I always put water at the front and the back of my cotton mat that's on top of the sticky mat, because the sticky mat gets very sweaty when you do hot yoga. And the reason I do hot yoga is because I believe it's best to do that. I've done all sorts of yoga. Yoga in a cold room, I think, is very dangerous. So this is just plain water. You can put a scent in it if you want. And I always spray a little bit of frangipani because I like the elevating scent. So I walk through it. This is just my ritual. So we're going to start with very basic moves. And each class will build upon the next level. But the very first thing all yogis should learn is the salutations to the sun. Surya Namaskar is the Sanskrit name, and it comprised of 12 different poses. So here we go. We started at the beginning of our top of our mat in mountain pose. I'm just going to speak. I'm not going to go toward the camera. And if you can't hear me, then I will get a mic. This is a test. So the very first thing, and a good way to start any yoga practice, is to feel connected to the earth. Because we are humans. We are connected to the earth. But in yoga, which means discipline, to yoke yourself to something, we're going to be lifting ourselves up, because we're also connected to all the cosmos. So feel the stretch between your spine as you stand with your palms towards you at first, and then just let them loose. And if you have rounded shoulders like I do, you can loosen them up, rolling them forward, rolling them backwards, and try to get those shoulder blades to kiss. And let your arms relax, let everything relax, and stand in mountain pose, Tadasana. feel the connection between the earth and the heavens above, the cosmos. We're going to start now with our hands at our heart and take a deep breath in. And take a breath out and release your hands. Take a breath in and reach up as high as you can. Staring at your thumbs if you can, but don't do anything that feels not good. And then relax and let your breath go, and slowly you can bend from your waist and bend at the knees, but eventually get down here. And even if you're here, that's okay. Eventually you'll get closer and closer to the floor, and you just want to have nothing going on except releasing whatever's going on in your spine. Stay here for a couple breaths. Feel the energy moving through your body. Feel the stretch in your lower body and your lower back. Take a breath in and put your fingertips on the floor and stretch your spine and look up and breathe out and come toward your body again. Breath in. Stretch up and really separate the tops of your legs as you breathe in. And breathe out and come forward and let the breath lead you through the nose. We always breathe through the nose. Breath in. Separate those hips. Look up and breathe out. We're going to be coming up now so you can bend your knees. If that feels good, it's much better for you to go very slowly. Vertebra by vertebra, and your head is the very last thing, so don't even think about your head yet. Get your rest of your body straight, elevated, spine, vertebra stacking, and finally the last thing is your head. Adjust your shoulders and come back to mountain pose. Beautiful. Once again, starting at our heart, breathing in. Breathing out, release your hands. Breathing in, up overhead. And release the breath and bend at the waist. Come forward. Hang for just one breath. Take your right foot and put it way back. The left foot is stacked right on top of the left knee. You have your fingertips up in what's called spider fingers. And you're going to put your knee down if you need to. If you don't, stretch it out. But if you do put your knee down, make sure to release that foot and just feel a nice stretch in your hip flexors. Looking up if you wish, or just straight ahead. And take 5 deep breaths. Now here is a very important first principle. It's called your gaze, where your eyes are. Is also called drishti. We're not going to use too many Sanskrit words, but drishti is easier to say, so it's fine. But that means your gaze, and it also means the expression on your face. So you never want a really harsh expression. You never want to look like you're exerting yourself. You always want a little Buddha smile on your face. Turned lips. Have fun, or else this is in yoga. One more breath. Put your hands down on the floor and bring the left foot back to the right foot. And here, in the course of 5 deep breaths, just have fun with this pose. This is down dog. Woo, woo. And we're going to go up and down if you feel like it, or if it feels better, you walk the dog. Or if it feels better, you can just go and have a little side twist. Whatever feels good. You want to make sure that your index finger on both arms is shooting straight out from your nice strong arms. Hands spread wide. Hands exactly shoulder width apart. Feet hip width apart. If you get tired, you can come down on your knees. You're building up arm strength if you don't have it. This is also an inversion. So it counts for getting the blood to flow. You don't have to go all the way to the floor with your feet. You can have them way up high. Eventually, you will come closer to the floor. If you have extremely tight hamstrings, you're going to have a hard time getting them any further than like that. You can make your triangle pose a little shorter if you need to. You want to be comfortable here. Whatever you're doing, make sure there's no discomfort. Now we're going to come forward, get to plank pose. Hold plank, strong. If you need to, you can put your knees down. Hold plank for 5 breaths, whichever way you are. And when you breathe, you want to make a noise. It's called Ujjayi breath. Put your knees down, release your feet, and let's do some push-ups. Keep those elbows close to your body. If that's too much, just do a little ones. Don't hurt anything. You're just building strength and lengthening, stretching, and everything is gradual. Stop doing push-ups and do some dancing cobras. Have fun with this. We're building up strength in our arms. Just having a little bit of fun too. The more you do yoga, you can just do whatever you want. So I urge you to do something spontaneously that comes into your mind or your body just starts doing it. Don't doubt yourself. Just let your body be your teacher. Bring yourself back to your feet. In a nice down dog. Whether it's a short down dog or a long down dog, doesn't matter. It's your down dog. It's perfect because it's yours today. Looking forward, you're going to bring the right foot, even if it's a hop, 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 even if you have to help it, it's okay. Eventually you'll just jump it up. Don't forget, you can put your knee down if you wish. And we're stretching out. Now here you want to grab the midline, it's called. Everything is squishing in. It's not floppy out. Everything's really centered around your spine. Looking up. One deep breath here. And we'll bring ourselves up to the standing, the bent mountain pose. We'll just go Uttanasana. And just hang here for a minute. And we'll bring ourselves up with a bent knee. And bring us all the way up. Reaching up. And gradually bring back to your heart. Beautiful. So that was our experiment for the day. Let's see how that is.